Hello all, we are back at our favorite channel, the Chatterbox Club. Today, let's explore an Indian forest and listen to a jungle tale together. Let's get started.
Dundul's Dilemma, Stories from Pipli 1, 2. Story written by Chandralekha Mehta and illustrations done by Ratna Reggi Mourinho. Published by Happy Squirrel, an imprint of Leadstart Publishing Private Limited. In the land people called Indh, there grew a vast forest known as Pipli Van. It was a wild and wonderful place full of many kinds of plants and trees, all competing with each other to reach up higher and higher to touch the blue sky. The forest was so dense that sunlight could hardly touch the ground. It was always cool in Pipli Van, even on a hot summer day. No people lived there, but it was the home of many animals and birds, all of whom lived together in harmony and happiness. They were the Piplis. Meeting of the Elders. There was great excitement in the forest of Pipli Van. The Council of Elders, who met every full moon, had decided to hold a talent contest in Pipli Van. Usually, the elders met to discuss and decide on serious matters which affected all the animals and birds who lived in the forest, known as the Piplis. Sometimes, the elders heard requests or complaints. At other times, they made new rules for the community. But this new moon, the elders decided it was time to get everyone together and see who was the most talented amongst them. The bird call post was in a flutter, rushing to every part of the forest with the news. Everywhere the Piplis came out to listen. In exactly 1 month, at the next full moon, the talent contest will be held at the central watering hole, Barapani. It was open to everyone who lived in Pipli Van. The busy ants were the first to call their own meeting. They formed a close circle with all their heads together and discussed their options. Finally, they decided to do a salsa line dance. They were sure they would win. The elephants conferred near the banana grove. They elected Jumba and Laya, their best dancers, to do the elephant waltz. They too were sure they would win. The butterflies held a secret conference among a field of flowers. They picked 50 of the prettiest colored butterflies to do the butterfly ballet. They were absolutely sure they would win. In another part of the forest, Kara the Koel decided to sing a solo. Dandu the stick insect was going to play his bamboo and reed guitar. Jura the peacock strutted around practicing his steps and saying his fan dance was sure to be the best. The crickets clicked their castanets loudly and thought Jura was a great show-off, and decided to put him in his place by winning the contest with their jazz band. Dundul's problem and Jani's advice. Only Dundul the frog was unhappy. He sat moping in his house looking at his silent harmonium. He so wanted to sing at the contest. Everyone loved his voice and he practiced every day. But just the day before, he had caught a cold sitting in the rain and lost his voice. He did not know what to do. Dundul lived in an old hut with a broken door at the base of an old gnarled banyan tree. In the same tree lived Jani the owl. He was one of the Council of Elders. No one knew how old Jani was, but his sharp eyes seemed to see everything. He liked to sit outside his house and meditate. After a few days, when Dundul hopped out to get some food, he heard the sage old owl ask him why he had not heard Dundul practice his singing for the last few days. Poor Dundul looked up at Jani and croaked that he had lost his voice. Jani knew Dundul was one of the most talented of the Piplis. It would be such a shame if he did not perform at the contest. So, Jani told Dundul to find Zizi, the queen bee, and ask for help. Dundul wondered what Zizi could possibly do to help him. But he thanked Jani respectfully and went on his way. Zizi lends a hand. Zizi was having a bath in the middle of her hive, surrounded by hundreds of her lady bees, all hoping to win a smile from her. Finally, she came out to meet Dundul, who was waiting patiently outside. Zizi was beautiful, and Dundul felt shy to ask such a lovely creature for help. But when she heard his problem, Zizi laughed her silvery laugh and told him to follow her. Off they went, Dundul trying to keep up, until they reached a green bed of herbs. Zizi flew down and sat next to Timmy Tulsi. She was a tall and graceful plant, and her green leaves fluttered in the breeze. When Timmy heard of Dundul's problem, she quickly bent down and took a few tulsi leaves from the ruff around her neck and handed them over to Zizi. She wished Dundul the best of luck for the contest. Zizi then flew back to her hive and asked her ladies to get some fresh honey from their store and mix it with the tulsi leaves. She then handed over a leaf cone with the mixture to Dundul, telling him to have it 3 times every day. Dundul did not know how to thank this beautiful creature. She just laughed and told him to make her proud at the contest. Dundul did not like the mixture Zizi had given him, but he obediently swallowed some of it every morning, noon, and night. Every day he tried to sing, but he could only croak in a dismal whisper. From his perch on the tree, Jani the owl kept an eye on his progress and smiled to himself. Just when Dundul had decided to give up, he suddenly woke one morning to find his voice had returned. He was beside himself with joy. Immediately he started practicing the song he had specially written. It was called The Song of the Forest. The Talent Contest. The day of the talent contest dawned at last. Everyone hurried to Barapani, the central watering hole, to find a good spot to watch the performances from. The sparrows, the mice, and the squirrels had been given the duty of clearing the area. Not only was it swept clean, but they had decorated it with colored berries and flowers. Finally, the Council of Elders arrived and were seated in the front row as guests of honor. Badur the monkey was the master of ceremonies and had worn a special hat for the occasion. He announced that the ants would perform first. Out came the salsa line and immediately everyone was clapping and stamping their feet to the rhythm. It was wonderful! The applause had hardly died down when Badur announced that Koel would now sing. Suddenly, the whole forest seemed to fill with beauty of the melody. Her pure voice seemed to soar into the sky. The audience was spellbound. Veru, the usually fierce tiger elder, had tears in his eyes, but pretended that some dust had got into them. The watering hole was filled with excited chatter. What an evening it was turning out to be! Just then the butterfly ballet started and everyone was amazed at the delicate movements and beautiful colors. The butterflies were like glimmering jewels. It was an amazing sight which everyone there would always remember. Then came Jumba and Laya in the elephant waltz, and the audience smiled as they swayed in time with them. They were such a graceful pair. The crowd roared for more. Bador announced a short break for everyone to get a quick drink and a snack. Khari, the rabbit aunt, and her many cousins were in charge of the refreshments. There was a great buzz of excitement all around. Who was going to win? They were all so good. In a while, Bador called everyone back to their seats, and in came Jura the peacock doing the fan dance. Jura was not much liked by the others because he was so vain about his looks. But today, everyone agreed that Jura's performance was dazzling. The sound of the guitar made everyone turn to see Dandu the stick insect come jiving in. Immediately, the audience were hopping to the catchy sound of the reed strings. He went faster and faster until his fingers were a blur. What a show! All this time, Dundul had been sitting quietly in the shadows. He watched each performer and got more and more nervous. How could he possibly compete? They would all laugh at him. But he saw Zizi and Jani sitting in the audience and remembered all the help they had given him. He could not let them down. When Bador called his name, Dundul hopped to where his harmonium stood in the clearing. Taking a deep breath, he opened his harmonium and began to sing the song of the forest. He closed his eyes and forgot his nervousness. He remembered only how much he loved this forest of Pipliwan with all Piplis called home. They were all friends and family. This was where they belonged together. Encore! Encore! Shouted the audience. Dundul opened his eyes and blinked. The applause rang through the forest. Every heart was won. Finally, Veru, representing the council of the elders, held up his hand for silence. The elders had decided that there was so much talent in Pipliwan that henceforth the talent contest would be held every year. But as this year's winner, the council had chosen Dundul the frog. Veru also announced that from that day, the song of the forest was to be renamed Anthem of Pipliwan. Dundul could not believe his ears. He had won! He had won! The song he had written from his heart in his little hut had become the anthem of the forest. Queen Bee Zizi swooped in and kissed him on the cheek. Jani the owl winked at him from his seat. All around him were shouts of congratulation and jubilation. Encore, Dundul! Encore! The end. Please like, share and subscribe my channel for more fun videos. And if you have any suggestions for Dundul or any other animal performers for the next year's contest, please feel free to email us at chatterboxclub88@gmail.com. so that I can convey the messages to them. Till then, take care and bye-bye. See you soon.